Hi, good afternoon everybody. Today we are going to learn software testing lifecycle. Okay, what is a software testing lifecycle? Software testing lifecycle, it is a process of testing of particular software or applications. In that one, we are having different stages. So in this one, first one is a test plan. Next one is the test scenarios, preparing the test scenarios. Next one is the test cases, test case execution, which is we are executing on given build. After that, publishing the test results. After that, if we found any defect, we are reporting, we are tracking, and closing, preparing the test closure report. So let's see these details one by one. So first one is the test plan. What is the test plan? So test plan which gives you proper idea of what are the testing activities to be performed on the given applications or software. What we are doing on testing. That is, it will give you a particular workflow of the testing. So which is having a detail, different details. So we will go through one by one. First one is the overview of the test plan. So where we are giving the, what is the purpose of the test plan, what is the scope, everything we are including in overview and the scope of the test plan. So which is give you the brief idea about the document. It is to be explained in the test plan. Scope of the test plan which will have the details of what are the scope, actually what test plan will do. These will details will give a scope of the application, sorry, test plan. So related document. So suppose you are preparing test plan, so on based which base you are preparing the test plan, suppose FSD, PRD, SRS, like this document. So okay, customer details means a client, who is a stakeholder, who is a client for particularly this application. Okay, so next thing we will go for testing scope. Testing strategy. So what are the strategies we are maintaining in the testing? Okay, and next, what are the scope of the testing? Actually, what is the scope of the testing you want to do? So with this test plan, you will know that this is the scope of the testing. By this scope testing, we can know that we will find this many number of defects and application quality is very good, like that. So risk. So what are the risk it is identified in this application? So mainly we are doing impact analysis. Okay, with the given requirement, if it is already developed application and if you received any CR, then you can find risk very easily. So we will, I think, for first of all, it is application came from very new application for developing and testing. So then we will include risk as a, suppose we have identified 4 testers. Okay, suppose one person is already resigned. So what are the risk it is identified? You need to recruit new person. It will take some time. So like this, you can write this type of risk. Okay, what are the deliverables? So by this test plan, what you will deliver? Test plan, FSD document, BRE document, test cases, test scenarios, defect reporting, test cases, execution report, like this scenario, these reports you will deliver in this test plan. It will mention. So test scenarios and test cases, okay. Testing team roles and responsibility, it will display, we need to describe in test plan, compulsory. What are the team it is exactly doing? They have to know by using test plan. So resource plan, if you for application banking or anything like the big application, you need more testers. So if you have 2 testers, so for recruiting, resource planning, you need to resource the planning according to testers. If it is less, you need to concern raise to HR team, like that. Okay, testing schedule means suppose one application decided to develop and testing for 1 year. So the, according to 1 year, we need to plan each and every date. At what date you will prepare the FSD documents, like FSD documents reviews. If you find any defect, any early defects in FSD document, you will report to the business analyst. So like this, according to this discussion, you need to mention each and every testing schedules, means test scenarios preparation. According to test scenarios, you need to prepare test cases. According to test cases, so once test cases should be reviewed, then only you need to get the test case approval from test lead. So test like this, you need to schedule everything, okay, for 1 year. Or 6 months or 3 months. Test environment. What are the environment you need for testing on this application? So according to test plan, by seeing test plan, you should know that these are the requirements for testing. These should be there before testing, like that. So defect reporting, defect life cycle, which is okay. We will see in the next class defect reporting. So then we will having a test scenario. So here we can see in this one test life, test scenarios preparation. Like the second one, okay. So test scenarios are to identify what are the possible functions you have to test in that application. Okay, according to scenarios, you need to prepare the test cases. Okay, test cases, test scenarios will prepare once the design documents are finalized. So without design document, you can't prepare test scenarios. Why? Because it is having functionality, buttons, text boxes. So like this home, about us, like these functionalities. So we will see the example of a test scenario. So here I have written 3. Suppose test scenario ID is test scenario 001. So which is applicable, e-commerce or banking or insurance, health, like that you can need to mention. So module is you will have a sign up, login, and home page, about us page, and services, like these details you will have different pages. Test case name. So what are the test case name? Test case underscore login. So these test case underscore login will have number of test cases, like check application displaying login screen. So in login screen you will see many details like username, password, okay, re-enter password, click on sign in, and clear button. So all these functionalities will cover in the login screen. So for one test scenario, that is test case underscore login, and test scenario 001, which is having so many test cases, validations with valid negative details, like this, you need to write one test condition, one test scenario. This is a test scenario condition. So okay, why this scenarios, you can write number of test cases. So like this, you need to write the scenarios for each and every modules, okay. So which is second coming to test cases, third one is the test cases. Here we have written test cases, right? So test case is to describe what have to be tested for a particular application in order to verify all the client requirements are working properly or not. So if requirements are not mapped, then you need to compulsory map all the requirement to the test cases. Then only you can prepare every test cases, and it should be mapped to the requirement. Then only that particular application is reviewed properly. Okay. So next here you will see test cases according to and test execution. Once test development has will give you particular bill, which is mentioning the what are the requirements are covered in this bill. Those requirements you should develop, you should test. Okay, that is the test execution. You will see after executing the test case, you will see results, which is a pass or fail. So like this, after that you need to report the defects in test management. We are actually using QC, Bugzilla, Jira, like that you need to report. So after reporting the defects, okay, developer will review the defect and he will try to reproduce it. Once he got that defect, then he will try to fix the defect. After fixing, you will see the status in test management, like a fixed. Okay, then you need to track the defect, like retesting, like that you need to do. So defect track, you should track the defects. What are the defects I have raised, what are the defects we have fixed, received fixed, then you need to retest everything like the defect. After all the defects are fixed and you have retested, there is no bug exist in application, then you need to close the defect, prepare the closure, defect closure reports. So then test closure report. Once all applications or particular module is tested and perfectly working, so like this integration will come for every modules, then you need to test all the applications with already raised defects. So like this, every defect should be closed. Then in UAT it is given for UAT, then the test closure report is prepared, which is having a different functionality to be tested, non-functional to be tested, what are the defects identified, what are the defects are open still now. So why? Because sometimes the defects will not fixed because of which is a minor, which is not impacting in client side. So client can use those perfectly, but these defects will be fixed in the next CR. Okay, like this, we need to mention everything in the test closure report. Okay, this is a software testing life cycle actually. These are the phases, test plan, test scenarios, like this. Okay, thank you. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, please share and like, and try to provide a knowledge to each and everyone so that you can remember more in software testing or software or any software application. Thank you.